Sadayam hidayam jasyo vachoh satya bhushitam Sadayam hidayam yasyo vachoh satya bhushitam Kayah parahitam yasyo kalihi tasakarotikim Gauriya Goshtipati, Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that to do Harinam and to meet with Hari, all the same. To do Harinam and to meet with Hari, all the same. This you can realize only when you are totally dedicated unto the lotus feet of a Namhayan Acharya. Those who are Namhayan Acharya, they are topmost. If you are going to make any mistake, aparad unto the lotus feet of Harinam, then it is dangerous, okay. But still, Nam Prabhu can compromise, can excuse you someday. But if you are going to make any mistake unto the lotus feet of any Nambhajan Acharya, then there is no way. If you are going to make any mistake unto the lotus feet of aparad unto the lotus feet of any Nambhajan Acharya, then there is no way. You cannot get any excuse. That is a big problem. Actually, the sloka I started with is not from Bhagavatam, but still is very important. What the sloka is very easy. Sadayam hidayam yasyo vachaha sattabhushitam kayaha parahitam yasyo kalihi tasyo karoti kim. Very important sloka. Here it is written, that if your speech is always speaking the truth, absolute truth, and if your heart is melted, if your heart gets melted for other people, those who are put into painful situation, to show mercy doesn't mean I can indulge in you. I can give you some indulgence, you can do whatever you like. It's very merciful, Maharaj. No. Somebody explaining this way. This Maharaj is very merciful, not speaking anything. Where is the Niti Satta is written that a father must get control over his child. If he allow his son to run fancifully, today or tomorrow he can become a vagabond personality, useless. So it's not good. And for Sadguru, it is more important. If for a material father, if it is so important that he should get control over his son, then what to speak about a spiritual father? He cannot speak anything. He can allow you to do whatever you like. It's called mercy. Then if you explain this way, then we will have to throw all Rasamrita Sindhu, Hari Bhakti Vilas, all Brihat Bhagavatamrita into Ganga. Then he can understand that what he was saying. But what all restriction there in Hari Bhakti Vilas, in Rasamrita Sindhu, all for us. If I think I am speaking big philosophy, speaking about so much restriction in bhajan line, but if in my personal life I am not going to follow anything, then I can never become a preacher. What is the What is the vital qualification of a preacher? I already discussed many times before. Upodesham karutyeva. Only he is advising others. Upodesham karutyeva. He is only advising you, not falling in his own life. That kind of advice is very dangerous. Upodesham karutyeva na pariksham. Upodesham karutyeva na pariksham karuti ja. He who is advising only and not testing those advice in his own life. I am advising you so strict, you are feeling so pain, Maharaj speaking so high. So you will have to detect that Maharaj himself following or not. That is most important thing. So in Shastra it is written, Upadesham karutyeva na pariksham karuti. It is not tested in my law. It is not tested in my own life. I am only advising you. What will happen then? It is written, Upadesham karutyeva na pariksham karutiya. Aparikṣa upadiṣṭam yat jagat nāsaya tad bhavet. Those advice not tested in my own life, but I am speaking, I am going to foreign country speaking. This kind of advice can ruin the whole world. That is the situation. Everybody can attack me because they cannot understand what I mean to say. With fighting mood they can come. But I am not speaking with fighting mood. I am in Vyasasan, I can trust Tulsi, Salak. No. Only I have my responsibility to speak all I heard from my Guru Bhargava. That is the duty I am doing. I have no other duty. Then upadesham karutyeva na pariksham karutiya aparikṣa upadiṣṭam yad jagan nāsaya tad bhavet. In I heard from Guru Bhargava in a very laughing mood. Guru Maharaj used to say, Guru Bhargava used to say, Paropadesha Pandit. You can advise to others. Not you are following. Paropadesha Pandit. You can advise to others. But not you are testing in your own life. So, first of all, you must realize this point. The first and foremost, the top. Why this kind of problem happening all the time? There is the only problem that we are not going to follow Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Jiva Goswami Pad, Rupa Goswami Pad. What all instruction they give, we want to make made easy. You know, one student not reading whole year. When exam coming, 15 days ago, he asked father, father, you can go to college street book market and get one made easy for me. I can just check up, made easy mean very easy. Gist only. If at all there is question, my luck is favorable. If I find all I read, I find, then I can get first division. Follow. This society is so foolish, idiot. They don't understand. I have seen my own wife. One student come out successful, but second division. And another student come out successfully, first division, very high marks. But I have seen my own life, that student, I mean second division, coming with second division degree, his depth knowledge, very deep knowledge, he is reading depth in awe. Like Einstein, he used to get very maximum number in mathematics and in physics, this. All other language group, this, that, all useless. Sometime 30 or not even 30. Why? So you can think he is useless? So this way we cannot pass judgment. Who is good, who is bad, is one fictitious term. Not actual term. We cannot, it's not scientific term. Before using, we must have sincerity and ability to test you. Otherwise, I cannot understand. So, actually, I started with a slok. Why I am speaking? This kind of speech, why I am speaking? I want to make a background. I want to make a nice background on which, on the basis of which I can discuss about Namacharya Haridasji, Haridas Thakur. I have no power to discuss about Namacharya Haridas Thakur. Only I can get that kind of power by the blessings of Haridas Thakur and Guru Varga. That much I can. I will have to depend upon their mercy. Out of my own false ego, I cannot represent some philosophy. I can represent some dry philosophy, but it cannot be my own feeling. Is the main point. I started with the slok is very important, but the second slok I see is also very important, very important. So I can match, I can show you, I can match, I can show you that how we can say Haridas Thakur is Jagat Guru. How we can say Sanatana Gosai, the topmost Acharya Tattvabid, giving direct indication, you, only you are the topmost Pacharak preacher, Sanatana Gosai speaking to Haridas Thakur. So we can discuss all about this tattva, the glories of Haridas Thakur. But the sloka I started with is very important, though not from Bhagavatam, but still very important. Sadayam hidayam jasyo, you know already, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing in his kirtan, jivedaya krishnanam, krishne sansar karo chariyanajar, jivedaya krishnanam, ei matto sar. So what do you mean by jivedaya? What do you mean by jivedaya? I can give nice sweet ball and coconut ball to you. Sweet, you can enjoy. It's called mercy. No. I can allow you to do what you are. It's too tough. We cannot obey. How we can? If I speak and one, you know, about what Prabhupada told, then nobody going to hear because they feel pain. Because they are coming in this Harikatha with maybe somebody, not all, with some different motive, I can realize. Any Shava, if Gurudev take me and make me sit in Vyasasana, you cannot see. When I do Vandana, automatically in heart, Gurudev speaking, Bhava speaking, that I can realize that in front of you, this kind of devotees sitting, so you can start this way. Automatically, I don't know why. You can test me. You can take me and throw me into a very rubbish society there. You can say I cannot speak Harikatha. Harikatha, I can pass lecture. That is different thing. But I cannot feel inspiration. But Harikatha, I can discuss. Not that in front of pure devotees only you can say, the what use, not that. At least environment should be there. I mean, hearing patience, at least should be minimum respect for Guru Vaishnava, minimum respect for absolute truth. Not that with fighting mood, this, that. Not that. So, actually, Sadayam Hidayam Dasa Yasa means, whose heart is always open. His heart is always melted by mercy. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, Jivedaya Krishnanam ei dharma sa. Jivedaya means, what do you mean by Jivedaya? Many devotees, they are giving me order, not request, I cannot say, I am a very small man. They are giving order, Maharaj, would you please start Upadeshamrita, this, that, long discussion, so that all thousands of people all around India are waiting for. They like to hear, to build up their spiritual life, but what time? But they're requesting, they're speaking in Hindi. But if I speak in Hindi, outside people cannot understand. Big problem. So, Sadayam Hidayam just so this word is just matching with what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking. Jivedaya Krishnanam Sarva Dharma Sar. Jivedaya means to show mercy upon a bonded soul so that you can help you, so that you can help him to cut Maya and get established in Hari Bhajan. Right, what I say? Many times, many people coming with fighting mood. Many people fighting with fighting mood. They're speaking, Maharaj, X mission, Y mission. They are doing so much social activity. What agenda you have in your chart? What you are doing? You Gauriya Math speaking so many things? Maharaj, they want to get that kind of facility. What all facility? Those facility relating to their body and mind. They want to get facility. What kind of facility? Which relating to their material body and mind? That kind of facility. That's why they are, you know, dancing and speaking their name. Oh, that ex-mission wise, very good. They are doing so much social service. What you are doing? What service you are doing? They think at the time of flood, if somebody coming with some dry food and throw from aeroplane or helicopter to the, you know, to those inundated people, they think it is one kind of benefit. They are so material. They cannot go beyond this conception of body and material mind. And very painful. Very painful. What to do? Actually, Prabhupada wanted to speak that it is our duty on behalf of Gauriya Math, it is our duty to find such a solution to find such a solution in your life so that in future you need not go for other support. Follow. Suppose you need some prasadam, nobody giving you, you are beggar. Maybe. If somebody giving you not prasadam, X mission, Y mission giving that prasadam up to this point. After that, the bandara is over there. In the night time, after going to bathroom again, they feel hungry. Then, so Gauriya Math always try to find solution with those bonded souls so that they never feel pain in their life anymore. This kind of activity is only done by Gauriya Math. Not by any spiritual organization like yoga organization and a karmi organization, maybe there. People, common people, they cannot understand. So Jivedaya means to help him to get sufficient consciousness so that they can get in touch with Krishna. That is called helping. Jivedaya. And Krishnanam, you can do Krishnanam because Jivedaya and Krishnanam is oriented with each other. If you cut one, another cannot stand. What I mean to say, those who are not doing Harinam, they cannot go for help to others. Follow? One thing, Harinam, another thing in Jivedaya. Two, almost one thing. If Jivedaya, this quality is there, then he must be doing Harinam, pure Harinam. Otherwise, how is he going to show Kipa? Automatically factor. So Jivedaya means 100% you are doing Harinam, I am sure. Otherwise, without doing Harinam, how you are going to show Kripa to others? So, Jivedaya Krishnam, you can see there is separate agenda, separate thing. You can, Jivedaya and Krishna, you can say, Mara, separate thing. No, not separate thing. But if you are a material personality, then in that case your conception is totally different. Those who are material person, they Jivedaya mean, so those who are material person, so by Jivedaya they mean, those who are material person, by Jivedaya they means to do something for their material body and mind. To do something for their material. So material person, those who are material, the thing that Jivedaya mean to do something good for their material body and mind, to give them medicine, to give them, you know, they are sick today, you can give some medicine. This way they are thinking. They are not thinking about the permanent solution which Gauri Mat can give. Anyway, so I started with a slogan, Sadayam Hidayam Jasso. He whose heart is always melted out of mercy to do something for bonded soul, only and only Vaishnava, only and Vaishnava can get that kind of quality. Sadayam Hidayam Jasso, Vachaha Sattabhushitam. Vacha means speech. Is not speaking any lie. But be careful to save Gomata, to save any helpless person from a murderer. If you speak lie, that's not bad. I've seen in my life. One people taking Gomata to cut. At Gomata, that gone, that rope, cut and gone. Running. And yes. And that Gomata, one very nice man, Brahmin, he never speak lie. He could understand that his, you know, his problem maybe. Because that's Muslim area. Then he case the Gomata and put inside, backside room. Then that Muslim people coming in, where? You have seen my Gomata? No? Where is Gomata? He's searching here and there. Where gone? Gone. If I want to save a chesty lady, Mataji, if I speak lie, no problem. For my motherland, if I speak lie, no problem. Follow. There is some indication there in Bhagavatam, but still I am giving some indication because otherwise you can misunderstand. So, who is always speaking truth? Follow. Sadayam hidam jasso vachaha sattabhushitam and kayaha parahitam jasso. And the body is always engage in the service of whole human being. I mean for Seva. Especially I am speaking, thinking about Vaishnava. Those who are the material Seva, I am not speaking. His body is like Prabhupada. Nobody can discover when Prabhupada used to take rest. Nobody can discover when Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj used to take rest. Hold Harinam. Maharaj, 84 course Vrindavan Parikrama, whole role playing Midanga and doing Kirtan. After that coming back in the evening time and started doing Harinam. When he is going to take rest? Huh? In the life of my Bhakti Pumapuri Goswami, night time 2 o'clock, some brahmachari going to bathroom and saying, light is on, open the room. Maharaj writing, Maharaj, you are not going to sleep today? Yes, yes, I can take sleep. It takes a little bit. After that, somebody 3 o'clock coming to that brahmachari to take the bath and start bhajan. Maharaj, you are not sleeping as yet? Oh, actually, no time. After that, arati ganta, dang, dang, dang. Guru Maharaj saying, today actually I am busy, I couldn't, oh, arati ganta is there, I cannot sleep today. So they have no time to sleep. In the life of Prabhupada, you cannot discover that Prabhupada is taking rest very nicely. The character of elevated Vaishnava is very confusing. Sometimes Prabhupada is going to Ceylon. Somebody says, Prabhupada is spending money to take rest there to recover health. Going to Darjeeling. Most confusing factor, they cannot understand. They can make fool of you anytime. Their character is so confusing, you cannot understand. He's doing this way, why? Confusing, you cannot understand. Maharaj giving facility, Acharya Dev. Prabhupada giving facility to this brahmachari, not giving to me. Why? Cannot understand. So many things happen. I have no time to discuss. So, sadayam hidayam jasso vachaha satta bhushitam kayaha parahitam jasso. His body is always engaged for seva, Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan, not for material people. You know, usually we are discussing about three kind of upakar, benefit. It is actually when you are doing something for yourself, then people say you are very selfish. Only you are doing for yourself. Not doing anything for others. So it is called in Sanskrit or Bengali, we say, Shartoparota, selfishness. Eh? But if you say he is not selfish, Maharaj, he is very generous people. Eh? Sartapar, Nishartapar. Oh, he is not selfish, Maharaj. He is very nice man. Okay. But we Vaishnav, we are less interested about Sartaparata and Nishartaparata. Selfishness and no selfishness. We are less interested about these two terms. Though the material people are all busy with these two terms. Selfishness and not selfishness. Free heart. But those Vaishnavas like Prahlad Maharaj, they are busy with Parartha-parata. Shartha-parata, Nishartha-parata, and after that one term is there, not known to you all. That is called Parartha-parata. A Vaishnava is always busy with this third thing. Parartha-parata means Shartha-parata, Nishartha-parata. Both discarded by Vaishnava, Guru Vaishnava. Parartha-parata means their whole life is dedicated to find solution of those bonded souls. To seek something good for them so that get in connection, so they can get, increase their consciousness and go up to that level, all their problem is finished. Because Atma is Chetan Vastu. Atma is Chetan Vastu. You don't understand. Guru Vaishnava can help you to come out of this Maya, this much. And Atma, their knowledge is itself there. Atma, with Atma knowledge is there, but it is suppressed. Only Guru can help you to cut that bondage, to uncover this much. After that, when you are getting consciousness, no Maya there, we can find light and light inside her. Like, for 200 years, this room is black, blackout. Suppose this room is in jungle, forest, big palace. And if from government some party coming to search, because something happened, if they are coming with big, big light, when one light if I on here, then maybe it is in darkness for 200 years, but as soon as I on the light, then within fraction of second, not fraction of simultaneously I can see what is what, where is what. Follow? So the Guru Vaishnava always want to help you to recover your consciousness, and you must be very sincere. You must be inclined. This no cup, no. You should be very fair. So now your body, when engaged in seva, Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan seva, then what Kali can do? Follow what I say. If this kind of qualities are already there in you, then what Kali can do? Kali can come to kill you. Kali can arrange so that infighting can take place in temple. Kali can come to murder you. Kali can stop your harikatha. But what Kali can do? What Kali can do? If this kind of quality is there with that sadhu, this Maharaj. That's why Parikshit Maharaj was bound to allow Kali to stay, persist. Influence of Kali is still there. So somebody, Shutadeva Adi is putting question, Maharaj, why Parikshit Maharaj couldn't kill Kali? Parikshit Maharaj could easily kill Kali. Male Parikshit Maharaj is sarango eva sarabhuk. Parikshit Maharaj is very clever. It's like honeybees. Honeybees, they are not going to disturb the flower. Only going to sit on flower, taking the honey and going out. No disturbance. Follow? So Parikshit Maharaj is very clever. He is Vaishnava. He could realize in Kali, though Kali is a treasure of evils. But still one quality is there. Kittanad eva krishnasya mukta sanga param brajet. Only by Harinam Sankirtan you can cut material bondage. Kali can do no harm to you. That is the topmost benefit we are enjoying in Kalikal. Still, influence coming on us because we are not enjoying those qualities I already told. That's why Kali putting influence, putting me in trouble. I cannot do Harinam properly, I cannot do bhajan, I cannot understand Guru Vaishnava. So Paratha Paratha is lying with Prahlad Maharaj. Paratha Paratha lying with Ambarish Maharaj. Paratha Paratha lying with our Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Paratha Paratha lying with Prabhupada, Keshav Goswami Maharaj. They never fear to speak about that absolute truth. They are speaking nicely. So that the whole society can give benefit. Now today is the disappearance day of Haridas Thakur. Today is the disappearance day of my Shiksha Guru Sisila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj. I am ever grateful to Bharati Maharaj. I am ever grateful to Haridas Thakur. Everybody can speak this way, those who are actual Vaishnava. You can remember, Kali came to put problem with Haridas Thakur many times. You can know. You know already. Many times. And I like to touch some important point so that you cannot misunderstand me. Yesterday I I was bound to discuss some points, but if I cannot discuss in details, you can misunderstand me. So I can, but in what background? Chaitanya Charitamrita background, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Leela background, Haridas Thakur Leela background. So you cannot charge me. Why, Maharaj, what you are speaking this way? No, cannot speak. Follow. You can remember when Haridas Thakur took resolution to do 3 lakhs Harinam in a very solitary cell there in Benapol. Actually, Haridas Thakur took birth there, at present it is Bangladesh, that time India, total Bharat. India and Bharat equal? If I say, Maharaj, we heard India is equal to Bharat. Bharat means India? No. Bharat, this name is very important name. Nobody knows. Bharat means Bha-Rataha. Bha plus Rataha. Bha means knowledge. Effulgence of knowledge, bha, teja, a power of knowledge, in which the inhabitants of India are always busy, like those sages. So, bha, ratha means engaged. Ratha means you don't know. So, long time you are staying here doing kirtan, you don't understand. I feel sorry.
আমার জীবন সদা পাপে রত নাহি কো পুণ্যে রলে
শোনো
পরের উদ্বেগ দিয়াছি যে কত দিয়াছি জীবের ক্লেশ
ইউ ডোন্ট নো নেভার নেভার ডু দিস কীর্তন হাউ ইউ ক্যান গেট প্রেমা হ্যাঁ ফুলিশ আমার জীবন সদা পাপের হতো ও প্রভু আই এম অলওয়েজ এনগেজ ইন সিনফুল অ্যাক্টিভিটিস রত মিন এনগেজ সো ভা রত মিন ভা নলেজ তেজা অফ নলেজ ইন এভিডেন্স অফ ইন্ডিয়া অলওয়েজ নাও প্রেজেন্ট দে আর গোয়িং টু ইমিটিয়েট ইউরো সোসাইটি ওয়াই আই ওয়াজ বাউন্ড টু স্পিক দ্যাট ওয়ে From European society, those people, they are coming in India to accept this, you know, Vedic culture. Whereas they, idiot, foolish people, they are going to mix with them and get back to that Euro culture. Abba want to speak. I have Tilak. I have Kanti. So I am Vaishnava. Hare. They are coming long way, leaving all property, this thing, that thing. They are going to lead their life very plain way, they want to follow me, not a matter of joke. Those people flying from me, oh, if we stay with Sam Baba, it's a big problem. Not possible, very hard. Hello, India is English name. It's not equal. Like, in dictionary you can find philosophy. But if I speak Darshan Shastra in India, that cannot be equal to this word, philosophy. Because as per dictionary, the philosophy means some sort of, you know, imagination is there. Philosophy is not equal to Darshan Shastra. Both people can say, you are foolish, Maharaj, we find this word there. Okay, you can find. There is no alternative. But still it is not equal. Because Indian philosophy, our, you know, Darshan Shastra, what do you mean by Darshan Shastra? What is what you must learn to see. That is called Darshan. But those foreign people who write dictionary, they think philosophy means some sort of dream, imagination. Some or other way this kind of conception can touch your heart. So, this is the point. So, Haridas Thakur actually wanted to do 3 lakhs Harinam continuously. And one advice you can remember that Prabhupada told, if there is anartha with you, if there is anartha with you, still go on doing Harinam. loudly. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, they all speaking this. Why are speaking? Those who are sahaja, they are speaking, Harinam cannot be uttered openly. They are foolish. But in Shastra it is written, Harinam param yapyam dheyam geyam nirantaram. Harinam param yapyam dheyam geyam nirantaram. Who told? Harinam you can do japa. You can sing. Harinam param dheyam geyam nirantaram. Param yapyam. Who told that Harinam you should not do? Haridas Thakur himself in his life doing Harinam loudly. Out of 3 lakhs, 1 lakh speaking loudly. Why? Because loudly if you speak Harinam, if you are pure Vaishnava, that transcendental sound vibration can propagate and touch your stavar jangam. The mystery was discovered by Haridas Thakur only. I can speak after some time. And those scientists also discover sound cannot be destroyed. It is staying in ether, oscillating. So Haridas Thakur, when Mahaprabhu discussing something special with Haridas Thakur about Harinam Tattva, Mahaprabhu speaking, Haridas, how those Muslim people, they can get benefit? Oh, Haridas, don't think, Prabhu. But actually, they are not doing Harinam. Oh, really, they are not doing Harinam. But still, they are speaking, Haram, Haram. They are speaking. That Ram doesn't mean that they are speaking Ram Nam. Haram means totally different word. Haram. Follow. So Haridas Thakur speaking, laughing, Prabhu, don't think. They are at least speaking Haram. Ham in exclamation and Ram in, though they are not going to utter the name of Ramchandra, still, Sanketam Parihasyam Stovam Helonemeva Vaikunta Nama Gohanam Aseshaga Haranam Bidu in Bhagavatam. Oh, I know they are not going to speak the Nama of Ramchandra, but still they are speaking Haram. Anyhow, they are speaking Haram, but still this can give benefit to them. Okay, Haridas, how those matters, I mean hills and trees, they can get benefit? Prabhu, maybe they are subconscious, little bit conscious, or half conscious, full conscious, according to degree. Chetan, Supta Chetan, Vikasita Chetan, Purna Vikasita Chetan, Chetan degree. But Haridas Thakur speaking, Prabhu, you can remember you are doing Harinam very loudly. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. When you are speaking Harinam in jungle, like where? But which jungle? Jharkhand. Then all tigers and, you know, lions, you know, and elephants, they together, and deers, they are dancing together. Elephant dancing. Prabhu taking bath in a pond and giving water to elephant, and those elephants, they are getting ecstatic laugh. They are dancing, laughing. They are laughing. Dancing very nicely. This way, Mahaprabhu was only, you know, because he was Supreme Lord. When Mahaprabhu was passing through Jharkhand, the theory written there in Bhagavatam came true. It is written in Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam, where? Dapar Yug. But in Kali Yug, we see it is applicable here. It was in Kali Yug, Dapar Yug there. In Bhagavatam, Bhagavatam is eternal, but still Krishna came in Dapar Yug, that Dapar Yug. There it is written in Bhagavatam, Vrindavane naishargiki sahasano ni migadayoho. Ni migadayo. The lions and deer can play. Only it is possible in Vrindavana. I have seen. One monkey and one small calf, they are playing with each other. Small calf. And that monkey, I mean, the, you know, playing with. I have seen, I was very laughing. How possible? The small calf and that monkey, very dangerous, they're laughing. Playing with each other. This way. So only it is possible in Vrindavan, but where Mahaprabhu is staying, Vrindavan can come. Jagannath Babaji Maharaj already proved a tiger is there in jungle, but the tiger was not ferocious that time. There is tiger, Baba. No tiger. It's the parshad of Gauranga. Go. No problem. He's going. This is possible, actually. So, Haridas Thakur, with Haridas Thakur, Mahaprabhu discussing so much thing, then Mahaprabhu speaking, Prabhu, when you are loudly speaking Harinam, that's Parinam, can get propagated all around. And Stavar Jangam, Stavar Jangam means fix up. Those are hills and trees. Jangam means those are moving. Those are elements. Both of them can get benefit. Now, if we speak from here, we cannot understand. That vibration going up, the radar of that, you know, satellite catching and giving to you. What high technology, you see. Follow, you see, how possible. This way everything. So now actually, Haridas Thakur, I mean Mahaprabhu discussing some special, you know, topics about Harinam with Haridas Thakur, because Haridas Thakur is the only personality with whom he can discuss this, because he is Namacharya. He is giving the title Namacharya. Namacharya Haridas Thakur, Sanatana Goswami, whenever Sanatana Goswami, Rupa Goswami, they are going to Purushottam Daya, they are staying at Haridas Thakur. Because they think we are not fit. Even Haridas Thakur cannot come inside Gambira Mandir. Be careful, otherwise you can misunderstand me. Yesterday I told so many tough. You have every possibility to misunderstand me. First of all, I can give answer to this, then I can go back again to that topic. Maybe it will take long time. So, you can remember, Haridas Thakur going to Puri, Mahaprabhu inside Gambira Mandir, looking here and there, where is Haridas? Then everybody running to road. Haridas! Prabhu calling you, come! Haridas lying on road and crying. You just inform to my Prabhu, I just cannot come inside. I am a fallen soul. I have taken birth in Javan family, so I cannot come inside. Please inform. You see, Prabhupada never wanted to put pressure on Haridas. You must come. Try to understand, but because Mahaprabhu wanted to keep balance. Mahaprabhu wanted to keep balance with both our spiritual benefit and social stature. Because Chaturvarna Maya system Guna Karma Vibhaga Saha, Mahaprabhu never want to break this system. Mahaprabhu never wanted to break this system because he is Krishna himself. And if we can apply this Varnasam Dharma, properly, scientific way, then we can get havoc result. You can fight with me, Maharaj, we are not getting result. That's the reason that you are not applying this Varnasam Dharma scientific way. never misunderstand me. Haridas Thakur was let, Haridas Thakur was allowed by Mahaprabhu, let him stay alone. Haridas Thakur begging for one solid, nice place in Aitota to do solitary bhajan there, and Mahaprabhu allow him. Mahaprabhu never put pressure on him. You come, take prasadam with, to keep balance. At the same time, inside Mahaprabhu giving topmost honor to Haridas. Haridas, you are topmost. Mahaprabhu keeping this kind of arrangement so that Haridas Thakur can get Mahaprasadam daily. Haridas Thakur can get Mahaprasadam daily. It was a standing instruction on Govinda. Every day after Mahaprabhu taking prasadam, the food remains prasadam. Haridas Thakur is topmost. He's the luckiest personality. He used to take that food remains prasadam, uchishta of Mahaprabhu daily. Follow. Also, you can remember when Mahaprabhu reached. When Mahaprabhu reached Varanasi, there Chandrasekhar Acharya, Chandrasekhar Acharya, and another, who? Huh? Tapan Mishra. Mahaprabhu used to stay in the house of whom? In the house of Tapan Mishra, Mahaprabhu used to take prasadam. But staying in Chandrasekhar, if I ask, why? Chandrasekhar is not Vaishnava? Yes, Vaishnava. Mahaprabhu, by example, wanted to set some example so that the whole system cannot break down. Why Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing Jaiva Dharma, Chaitanya Sahib in such a way so that people have their less possibility to misunderstand? Bhaktivinoda Thakur said, well, you are taking skirted, you are not, you are actually Paramarthik Brahman. But for that you cannot go to society to snatch the duty of Brahmin people. Follow? You have no right to snatch the duty of other people. It is most dangerous. According to your quality, you are going to follow your line. When Mahaprabhu reached Varanasi, there Mahaprabhu is putting this kind of example. When Mahaprabhu going to Vrindavan, you can understand the Sonoriya Brahman. Sonoriya Brahman, Mahaprabhu dancing there, that Sonoriya Brahman also. After that, Mahaprabhu took information, he is a disciple of Madhavendra Puripad. And also, Mahaprabhu heard from him that from Sonoriya Brahman, Madhavendra Puripad took prasadam in their house. When Mahaprabhu heard, Mahaprabhu tell, Mahaprabhu speaking, whatever be the system, if one pure Vaishnava, my Guru Varga doing, I should follow this. Follow. Madhavendra Puripad took prasadam in your house, so though it is not, this rule is not applicable in general, but still I can take. There Mahaprabhu not going to play. Follow. Mahaprabhu was bound to take prasadam there. Because Mahajano Yeno Gato Sapanthya. So in this way, what Bhagavan Sri Krishna wanted to speak, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to speak, Mahaprabhu never wanted to break down the whole system. Because everybody not Vaishnava. Everybody not Vaishnava. Those who are pure Vaishnava, Vaishnava, they are going to follow this rule. Those who are not Vaishnava, If the whole system breaks down, then big problem. I can explain Gita, then I can show you how Bhagavan Sri Krishna is so conscious about the whole society, about hybrid. Sankara Narakayaiva. Never, even Sabji, Even fruits, hybriding is totally prohibited. Cannot have, but still people doing, what to do? Hybrid not allowed. Not allowed. It's dangerous. Krishna Bhagavan speaking is not allowed actually. So in this way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, irrespective of caste and kids, be careful. Somebody speaking, Mahaprabhu actually destroy the whole social system. But not, they cannot just prove it. Mahaprabhu never breaks social system. One by one I can give example. But this much you can say, irrespective of their caste and creeds, irrespective of their country, irrespective of their body, their woman or man, they, irrespective of their position, follow, caste and creeds, country, no matter. Because bhakti is a natural function of your soul, not your body. Not your body. You can get bhakti. You can do bhajan perfectly under the guidance of Guru Vaishnava. You can go up to the level of Brahmanism, maybe. Still, you have no right to break the whole social system. Follow what I mean to say. Irrespective of caste and creeds, Mahaprabhu distributing kippa to everybody. To everybody. But still Mahaprabhu never wanted to break the social system. So much fighting going on about why Prabhupada giving Brahman skarthe to everybody. Prabhupada giving answer, Brahman and Vaishnava of this quality. Follow. Each and everybody from different source they are coming. They have some genetical factor different, blood different, food habit different, conception different. Follow. They are born and brought up in different culture. Gradually they can come and take, adopt this, you know, this Vedic culture. They can get accustomed, okay. They can go up and up in bhakti, no problem. They can come out successful in bhajan. Not that they cannot come. But for that, we cannot break the social system. In Bhagavatam, you can remember, I can discuss this point later because today's topic is totally different. Sutadev Goswami, about Sutadev Goswami, it is written there, Sutadev Goswami himself speaking. Bilomo Yata. Bilomo Yata mean? Bilomo Yata mean? If father Brahman, mother Kshatriya, Anulom, total opposite. I mean mother Brahmin, father. Follow. Try to, it's scientific. If people cannot understand, they can misunderstand me. It is not bad system. But it is, we are applying this Varnasam Dharma badly. We don't know how to apply. In this Rishi Samaj, that time, in the society of those Rishi Manis, they used to apply it very properly. But at present, total, you know, anticlimax, degradation of humanity, everything going on, coming down. High thoughts, they want to prove that it is, no, it's useless. That means, what you mean to say, Krishna is liar. You want to speak, na? Huh? You want to prove that Krishna is a liar. Haridas Thakur, Sanatana Gosai, Rupa Gosai. Why Sanatana Gosai not going to Jagannath temple? Whereas Haridas Thakur and Sanatana Gosai took birth in high Bharadraj family. High! Topmost Brahman. Still they are crying. We are always with evil association, low Muslim, Javan, Sangha. So we have no right. We are fallen soul. We have no right to go inside Jagannath temple. They are speaking. They used to look the Jagannath wheel. pay prostrate to Dandavad and took prasadam. Whenever Mahaprabhu calling Sanatana Goswami, Sanatana Goswami used to go that way, backside way. One day it was very scorchy sunlight. Mahaprabhu, you wanted to meet Mahaprabhu? Sanatana coming? Someplace. First of all, Mahaprabhu knowing. Mahaprabhu asking, Sanatana, which way you are coming here to my place? Prabhu, I am coming sea beach, through sea beach. Through sea beach? Why you don't come directly here? It's very shortest route. Prabhu, how I can come? If I come this way, some panda, those who are the servant of Jagannath, they're serving Jagannath, I can touch them somehow. Then I can get some aparad. So, Mahaprabhu was very, very happy. You develop some bubbles, you see your leg. Your leg burnt up. Mahaprabhu speaking. In my life also, I go barefooted. Since after the running, I develop some problem. Long ago, that time Guru Maharaj was there in Puri. I wanted to show Vairagya and then go. After that whole road, what to go? No money to buy chapal. Big problem happened. So this way you see, system is okay. But application should be scientific. System is all okay. But application should be scientific. If you are doing misapplication, then you are going to get bad result. That's why actually Haridas Thakur, be careful. Haridas Thakur giving different answer to whom? Whom? Mahaprabhu. You can remember one time Haridas Thakur going to Saptagram, there in the village of Raghunath Das Goswami. There everybody pay honor to Haridas Thakur ki jai. And Hiranyagavardhan, uncle and the uncle of Hiranyagavardhan. They arrange big, you know, they wanted to get good association, I mean satsanga. They arrange satsanga. Haridas Thakur was allowed to speak all the glories of Harinam. Very nice. And be careful. That time Raghunath Das Goswami was a small boy. That time Raghunath Das was a small boy. He used to meet Haridas Thakur and do some seva that time. Haridas Thakur used to go, usually. There when? Well, Haridas Thakur used to stay there for some time. Saptagram. There, the big mammoth gathering there. So many people coming to attend the Harikatha Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur always speaking about the glories of Harinam. Then in between, one servant is a service holder of Hiranyagavardhan. They have their department. They have their department to collect tax, land tax. Because that time the king was given responsibility. Follow. And Ujir, he is one kind of police. I mean, looking over the overseer, maybe you can say. He is supposed to get some amount, but they are not giving. That is totally different topics. Now, actually, Haridas Thakur is speaking all about the glories of Harinam. In between, one young man is his name in Gopal Chakravarti. He is standing and speaking. You are actually false philosopher. You are speaking all rubbish. Those who are doing STD and finances, they cannot get that thing. And through only Harinam they can think. Bhabuk, foolish. You are speaking all. Then all sabha become very standard. Why you are insulting Haridas Thakur? You can meet with big danger. They think we are, you know, big. We are having thorough knowledge and Shastra, but they are not knowing anything. They have no relation. Haridas Thakur is very smiling mood speaking, why you are not going to believe? Harinam itself has that kind of quality. Why you don't believe? Why you disbelieve me? If you can prove that Harinam has that kind of quality, then I can cut my nose. Otherwise, you will have to cut your nose. Everybody crying, oh my God. He is speaking this way, insulting Haridas Thakur. Everybody was very sorry. Then Haridas Thakur is smiling mood speaking. Why you all are sorry? He has disbelief at heart. That's why you are fighting. You need not. After that, within 3 days, that Gopal Chakravarti developed leprosy. He is very nice. He demand that I am from Brahmin family. Very nice nose. Very nice looking. All his nose, everything melt up. Hand, everything melt up. Leprosy. Within 3 days. Then everybody is seeking right punishment given by Supreme Lord. Nice punishment given by, proper punishment given by Supreme Lord. This is the power of Haridas Thakur. You can remember when Haridas Thakur started doing Harinam, 3 lakh Harinam there in the solitary castle of Benapo. Then there one demon is there, Ramchandra Khan. He wanted to insult Haridas Thakur because the image of Haridas Thakur, because the image of Haridas Thakur is big, high in the society. In the society, the image of Haridas Thakur is so high, nobody can look so high. So he wanted to bring him down from his own position. So he arranged his plan, he is plotting very nice. He consult one harlot, pros, with big amount exchange. I can pay you. You can prove that Haridas Thakur is loose character. You will have to prove that much. After that, I can pay you heavy amount. Well, it's very easy. I can go. I can send police with you. No need. I myself is sufficient. That harlot with nice ornament and everything, decoration, and very nice going there. Haridas Thakur doing Harinam. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. That time, the harlot, going there, she is habituated in this Hindu society. She is going to pay Dandavat to Tulsi. Parikrama and Dandavat, because they have jet, everybody knowing in India, everybody knowing. Bharat. In Bharat, everybody knowing. Maybe in India, not everybody knowing. In Bharat, everybody knowing. So, there what happens? That after that, sitting in front of Haridas Thakur and speaking all rubbish. You are very nice looking young chap. I like to get your association. Who is there to resist after saying, oh, I cannot. I am in love with you. Please save me. Haridas saying, I can give you nice association, my association. You can wait. But only the thing, you will have to wait for some time. How long I will have to wait? I cannot wait anymore. You will have to wait because I am initiated in Harinam. I have some resolution to complete Harinam. Satakati Harinam Yogya in 1 month. So you will have to wait. How long will you wait? After that, she is hearing Harinam, Hare Krishna, Krishna. Morning time, dawn. That pros is feeling disgusted. She is going and reporting to whom? Ramchandra Khan. Today, actually, he already promised me. Today, he couldn't complete his Harinam. Tomorrow, he can give me association. No problem. Okay, you can wait. Next day, same thing happened. Next day, same thing happened. Haridas Thakur speaking, wait, today also, I think today I can complete my quota. I think today I can keep complete my quota of Harinams. You will have to wait still more. Okay, as you like. I promise you, I can give you association. Big sadhu, he promised me many cases, he cannot speak lie. Then he is doing Harinam. Then he is Harinam. Morning time, please excuse me. I beg for pardon. to still today I couldn't complete my quota. Maybe today night I can complete. Again that Allah came with a great desire, great. Today successful, no problem. Haridas Thakur doing Harinam. After hearing 3 days consecutively, whatever dirtiness is there inside the heart of that harlot, all cleaned up, all clear. That is called Jivedaya. Haridas Thakur, three days actually considered Harinam. Then the harlot pay posted at Dandavas under the lotus feet Haridas Thakur to speak out the truth, actual fact. Thakur, I was saying to prove that you are loose character. Haridas Thakur smiling, I know already. That's why I'm waiting here. Now, see, change your heart. I want you to take shelter onto the lotus feet of Haridas Thakur. Then Haridas Thakur is saying, go and take bath. Distribute all ornaments of money that you have acquired in your life through this bad job, prostitution. Go and distribute. Among Brahman, Vaishnav, you don't distribute, go. And then come to me with one single cloth. You should not have any deposit. Why? Harinam can maintain me, na? Yes. Through Harinam I can get everything. Nishyased naiva vishvasa kadaruddha bhavishvati kitta niyato balyad harinamaiva kevalam. Nishyased naiva vishvasa. Why? When I can fall down and die? Nishyased naiva vishvasa. Nishyased means breathing. Nishasen noiva vishasakodaruddha bhavishvati kittanyo to balyad haren namaiva kevalam. Then Haridas Thakur, when that harlot, cross-coming in front of Haridas Thakur, then Haridas Thakur giving Harinam to him. You sit here, do Harinam here, all prasadam can come to you. You need not go to, prasadam can walk and come to you. You need not walk down here and there. Prasadam can come, walk and come to you. No problem. Prasadam can, Narada already proved with that bad hunter. Prasadam can come to you. Prasadam can run and come to you. You do Harinam. Then after that, what happened? All big Acharya and best of society, they are coming to take darshan, the lotus feet of that Lakshahira, who has just tomorrow a pros. No. This is the quality of Haridas. That's why it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Haridas Thakur is just touchstone. Mahaprabhu speaking, Haridas is a jewel of this earth. I heard in my childhood that Kahinur diamond was taken away by British people. Kohinur, one big, you know, diamond. You never in this world available. But Mahaprabhu speaking, you are a rare jewel of this earth. Haridas Thakur is a jewel of this earth. And in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Chaitanya Bhagavad is written, Haridas Thakur is touchstone. And Haridas Thakur is such a powerful touchstone that Haridas Thakur can touch you and make you a separate touchstone. What is the duty of a touchstone? If I touch a touchstone, iron piece, with touchstone, that iron piece can get converted into gold. Haridas Thakur not going to convert Lakshahira into gold. Gold? No! Haridas Thakur going to make her a separate touchstone so that Lakshahira can change the life of others. This is the capacity of Haridas Thakur. You can remember when Haridas Thakur crying, Prabhu, you are going to Purushottam Dham, I have no power to go. How I can live? Mahaprabhu speaking, I can take you with me. Don't think I can take you with me to Purushottam Dham. Really so? Haridas Thakur was given a nice place there. Backside this Gambira Mandir, Tota, I Tota, used to do Harinam whole day. And in a day, one time, Prasadam coming, Jagannath Prasadam, I mean, Mahaprabhu Prasadam, Govinda bringing and taking Prasadam. And when Sanatan, Roop, anybody, when they are going, they are staying in Haridas. They are also taking that Prasadam. Now one day in front of Mahaprabhu, in front of Mahaprabhu, Haridas Thakur crying and speaking, Prabhu, I think you are going to go away from this material. You are going to withdraw your Leela. I think in my heart I feel that surely you are going to withdraw your Leela. Your Leela. Withdraw your Leela from her. I feel. So it is my request to you. Don't try to show this Leela to me. Better you can take me away before you discover this Leela. Before you discover this Leela, please take me away from this material world. I like to go away. Mahaprabhu speaking, what Haridas? All my Leela, everything with you. If you like to go away from this material world, how I can live? Haridas Thakur crying and speaking, I am one kind of insects, insignificant insects. There is countless Brahmanda, countless infinity world there. And like me, there is so much, so many, you know, those who are going to help in your Leela, don't try to think over and again about me. Please, it is my request to you. Please, you try to take me away before your disappearance Leela. I cannot bear. Then after that, Mahaprabhu gone that day. Next day in the morning time, with Charan Tulsi, everything and coming and asking, Haridas, how you are? And the previous day I told you, no? Haridas Thakur lying and chanting Harinam because cannot sit properly. Govinda coming with Prasadam, asking, Thakur, you come and take Prasadam, I bring Prasadam for you. Actually, what to do? I cannot take Prasadam. Why? Because today I cannot complete my Harinam. Today I cannot complete my Harinam, but you bring Prasadam, what to do? You bring Prasadam, I must pay respect to that Prasadam. I must pay respect to Prasadam, okay? So, Prasadam, then after that, Haridas Thakur speaking, one pinch of Prasadam was taken by Haridas Thakur and put on tongue. One pinch. Haridas Thakur speaking, today I couldn't complete my Harinam, so I have no right. Today I couldn't complete my Harinam, so I have no right to take Prasadam. But you bring Prasadam, I must show honor to that Prasadam. Mahaprabhu coming and asking what happens. Then this way, Haridas Thakur crying and speaking, Prabhu, at last moment I like to see your lotus mouth. I like to take your lotus feet on my chest and look your lotus fish, fish. And I should get that kind of opportunity, rare opportunity. You promise me, you can give me. Then Mahaprabhu speaking, what to speak? Krishna can grant anything what you like. Krishna can grant whatever you like. Don't think. Follow. And next day, when Mahaprabhu coming morning time, then Haridas doing Harinam very, very slowly. Mahaprabhu asked, what happens, Haridhar? What is the problem? What disease? Mahaprabhu asking, what disease with you? Kon vyadhi Prabhu kahe, kon vyadhi kaho to nirnoy? Prabhu asking, what disease you develop today? Haridas speaking, no, my body is very nice, but only the disease is that I cannot complete my Harinam. Only the disease that I cannot complete my Harinam, this much disease. Then Haridas Thakur speaking, hey, Mahaprabhu speaking, you are actually Siddha Mahatma. You are just Siddha Mahatma. Why you are taking care so much about to completing your Harinam quota? You can do less Harinam. I cannot do. After that, next day when Mahaprabhu came in the morning time, then Mahaprabhu started Sankirtan with full troops, full Parshad. They all started, Sarup Gosai, Rayanama, everybody. Even that time, Rupa Goswami Pad was there, dancing. Doing Sankirtan. And in the middle, Haridas Thakur giving some indication. Prabhu, please, please come to me. Please, please. Because already Haridas Thakur told him. Then Mahaprabhu knowing his heart, just coming beside him. Then taking the lotus feet of Mahaprabhu and setting on the chest. And looking at the lotus mouth of Mahaprabhu. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Nam Karita Uccharan Deher Sahita Pran Karila Niskaman. With Sri Krishna Chaitanya live body. Because Haridas Thakur wanted to speak that way. Haridas Thakur already wanted to get that kind of a benediction from Prabhu, you promise I can speak your Nam in my tongue, I can look your lotus mouth, I can take your lotus feet on my chest, and then I can leave my body. You will have to grant this application. Well, Krishna can grant. When Haridas Thakur leave body, Mahaprabhu crying and shouting, today we can remember that who in the Kurukshetra battlefield, who Pitama Bhishma. Today I remember that how Haridas Thakur living body is just like who? Pitama Vishya. Oh, so lucky. Mahaprabhu crying and speaking. I wanted to get his association long, but my luck is not good. I'm missing him. Svatantra Krishner Ichha Hoilo Sangha Bhanga. Kipakori Krishna Diyachilo Sangha. Krishna was very merciful to give me the association of Haridas. Now Krishna is always, you know, he never want to follow anybody. Svatantra means independent. So now Svatantra Krishna Richa, now today I am going to lose Haridas forever. Mahaprabhu, tears rolling down his cheeks, taking the body of Haridas Thakur in lap, taking the body of Haridas Thakur in lap, started dancing very heavily. After that, they make a palanquin, I mean, arrangement, so that they can take Haridas Thakur up to the sea. Then Mahaprabhu himself, taking the water of sea and, you know, bathing the body of Haridas Thakur and speaking, giving indication to the sea, the sea, you are today pure enough, you are pilgrimage. Mahatirtho, Mahaprabhu speaking, oh sea, today you are by the touch of the lotus feet of Haridas Thakur, now you are actually Mahatirtho, not Tirtho, not pilgrimage, topmost Tirtho, you are getting this title today. Follow. After that, Mahaprabhu crying and crying, taking this body, because they are digging one place in the sand, sea beach, and putting the body of Haridas Thakur with mala, everything inside. Mahaprabhu was the first to give, you know, sand. After that, all devotees, Mahaprabhu, you all can give sand on the transcendental body of Haridas Thakur. They are all giving sand. After that, Mahaprabhu himself making a nice, you know, pillar just with hand. Very nice. After that, what happened? Mahaprabhu putting one tusi, one tusi there on. And Mahaprabhu dancing, doing kirtan all around, and ultimately going to Jagannath temple inside to beg for prasadam. Mahaprabhu with clothes, speaking in fine in front of those pandas, give me Mahaprasadam, I am begging to you, because I want to arrange one big feast festival, Maha Utsav of Haridas Thakur. Everybody all coming with big, you know, pot, mud pot, to give Mahaprasadam to Mahaprabhu. Then Swarup Gosai come, stop. Prabhu, please you go. I am coming with Mahaprasadam. Don't worry. I am coming with enough prasadam, you go. All those who are selling Mahaprasadam on this panda, they want to give whole. Mahaprabhu himself asking Jagannath. They want to give whole. No, I don't need so. Then Swarup Gosai with four men, taking so much, lot of prasadam, and going Jagannath Ballabhudhan there to arrange a big festival there, Mahamahotsav. Then Mahaprabhu started, you know, distributing prasadam in himself, taking prasadam, giving. Four men with Mahaprabhu himself, first. And one man can take this much prasadam, Mahaprabhu giving so much prasadam. Four, five people cannot take Mahaprabhu give. Swarup Gosai, Prabhu, they cannot take that much prasadam. You go, you sit. No, I can distribute this seva. No, you sit. If you cannot take, if you are not going to take prasadam first, they cannot take prasadam. You are not thinking. So better you sit. I am distributing prasadam with Shankar, everybody. They are now distributing. Then Mahaprabhu, Kasimisu, Kasimisu, the king, I mean, the, you know, Pandit, Raj Pandit, he also brings so many prasadam. And Mahaprabhu taking prasadam, before taking prasadam, giving jayakar. Mahaprabhu promised those who are going to participate in the kirtan of Haridas Thakur, Nirjan, those who are going to take the Charanamrita Haridas, because Mahaprabhu allow, hey, take Charanamrita Prasadam. When Mahaprabhu going to see and taking, giving bath, that time everybody taking Prasadam. Charanamrita. Those who are going to take Charanamrita, those who are going to put sand in Samadhi, those who are dancing, doing kirtan, even those who are not doing anything out of, those who are going to take prasadam in this Haridas Thakur Nirjan, my Haridas, I promise they can all go to Golok Vrindavan. It is my commitment, I promise to you all. Can you think the glories of Haridas Thakur? Can you think that how Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj is so lucky that this day Bharati Maharaj is going to leave body? Whole life Bharati Maharaj is doing Harinam, proper Harinam. We in the Vaishnava society always speaking Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Maharaj and Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, two jewels. In Gauriya Math we speak. Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj is a jewel. His brain is not just equal to 100 computers. It's not just hundreds of computers can fail. So powerful his merit. Always, you know, always doing Harinam Sankirtan. Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. Why Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj is so important in Vaishnava society? Anybody who not, after all our Guru Varga gone, Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, after all our Guru Varga gone, after all our Guru Varga gone, Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Vedanta Vaman Goswami Maharaj, a giving honor. After everybody gone, still we are going to get some pillar. We are going to get some pillar to hold on. That was Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. My Guru Padmani used to say, if I leave this material world, then don't feel sorry. Any problem you meet, you can go to Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj and ask. He can solve. Why Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj is so important? I have seen Narayan Maharaj used to call him in Sabha, give full honor to him. Full honor. I have seen every time. Except Bhakti Maharaj, if Bhakti Maharaj at all they are in Vrindavan, calling, must come. First, in Sabhapati you must speak. So much honor was given. Why? Because Bharati Maharaj was really so important personality. Exalted personality in this Vaishnava world. I cannot pay him. So much benefit I got from Bharati Maharaj. He was so important. Why? Because he was full of seva, whole life. Never we see Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj is out of seva. Whole life, how to do Guru Seva, how to take responsibility, big function. Because specially Bhakti, our Bhakti Siddhanta Mahadev Goswami Maharaj has some speciality. He used to arrange big festival, big arrangement. Who is going to get control? Nobody there. Bharati Maharaj, always, who can take responsibility? Gurudev, I am there, no problem. Always. Bharati Maharaj always taking this big function, big things. Not only that, Gurudev used to give order, you call Narottama Brahmachari when he was Brahmachari. Call Narottama Prabhu can speak some Harikatha. Narottama fear actually, no, he must come. He is knowing Tattva, he is Bhakti Dvaita Madhava Goswami Maharaj used to speak in a big way. I am very lucky. You must think that Narottama Brahmachari is the ideal Brahmachari in this version of society. Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj used to say, Bhakti Dvaita Madhava Goswami Maharaj, Narottama Brahmachari is the ideal Brahmachari in this Vaishnava society. we must follow him. Everybody should follow him. So, even a single spot you cannot discover in the character of Bharati Maharaj. I am so proud. I am the disciple of Bharati Maharaj, Sikha disciple. In whole life, you cannot point out a single instant when somebody can point out that Bharati Maharaj has done some mistake. His character is so high, Vaishnava, so pure. His etiquette. Either Madhav Basi Maharaj used to pay honor, you don't know. I heard from Guru Maharaj, one day, Brajamandal Parikrama going on. Then Brajamandal Parikrama going to Chapahati somewhere else. They are going to a house, big field, they are kirtan going on, everybody taking prasadam. Mane fruits and these, their sweets. Bharati Maharaj not taking. Gurudev watching. Now what happens? No, actually I cannot take prasadam. Because Bhaktivedanta Madhukar said, no. There is a house where he don't like to take prasadam. He is very careful. Then Bhaktivedanta Madhav Goswami Maharaj singing one kirtan in front of Narottama Brahmachari. In front of Narottama Brahmachari, not going argument, but doing one kirtan of Bhaktivedanta Thakur. Sapacha grihate mangya khaibo pibo saraswati jala. Sapacha grihate mangya khaibo pibo saraswati jala. You can remember this kirtan. Because Bharati Maharaj, no. Bhagavan knowing well, this house we should not take prasadam. But anyway, very careful. Bharati Maharaj, so, mani, we find one example in our life. Many times, I follow Bharati Maharaj in his preaching after Guru Maharaj gone specially. I was there with Bharati Maharaj. I don't know what kind of love and respect he has for me. In Jalandhar, everywhere. Bharati Maharaj speaking. I am sitting like a foolish man. Bharati Maharaj, big Vaishnava speaking and speaking with shrugging head. Bharati Maharaj openly declared, but that time Tirtha Maharaj was not there. Now our Sambhava can speak something. I say, Maharaj, I can speak. What I can speak in front of you all? No, he must speak. So liberal heart, so big heart. Never I have seen any envious attitude. Anybody coming, anybody, whole, you know, Chaitanya Gauriya Math society, anybody coming in Gauriya Math, first seeking, where is Bharati Maharaj, where is Tirtha Maharaj? Where is Bharati Maharaj? Bharati Maharaj is like eyes. Without Bharati Maharaj, we are blind. We cannot see anything. All big responsibility was given by Gurudev to him, Bhaktivedanta Madhav Goswami Maharaj. What not? At present, I can call a topmost, you know, engineer, construction engineer. But I can put Bharati Maharaj near. But Bharati Maharaj can prove that my knowledge is more than you. Bhaktivedanta Madhav Goswami Maharaj never used to call any engineer. My ready-made engineer is there, Bharati Maharaj. Narottama, how we can construct within this small piece of land? Gurudev, no problem, I am there. Bharati Maharaj seeking all, everything, all square. When one man can reach old age, Bharati Maharaj, when doing construction, thinking everything. When this Vaishnava can grow age, how they can go, he is also thinking. How to construct Nath Mandir in this very small piece of... You can go to Calcutta and see. Small piece of land. How it is possible to arrange this so scientific way? Big construction. In Dehradun, everybody failure. That's not possible. A small piece of land, how we can... DL road. Small piece of land, how we can... Both Nath Mandir, Mandir... kitchen room, Vaishnav, guest house, not possible, not possible. Maharaj speaking, don't worry, I am going. Making such a plan, so you can go mad.
You can go from roadside, if you climb a staircase, you can go to temple up. And from inside room, those who are staying inside, they can also go to. There are so many rooms and everything, kitchen room, everything there. I've been there many times with Bhakti Vallabhsitthakasinathan Bharati Maharaj, many times in, I was feeling, how is possible to construct this way? So brain, we are missing. Bharati Maharaj gone mean we are missing everything. Bharati Maharaj gone mean we are missing. I have nobody at present, I am in Vyasasan. I feel so much. I have nobody to go, whom to, where to go, whom to ask. Though Gurudev giving answer from her, but still I like to meet one Vaishnava to discuss something. But Bharati Maharaj was there. Any writing I write, I used to show you. Very nice. Go, print. Any kind of criticism people doing, I am going to give answer. First I go to Bharati Maharaj, check up. I am giving answer to their criticism. Very good. Go. Nobody can do any harm to you. You can print. Yes, you see. Giving so much power to me, giving so much energy to me, is rare. After Guru Maharaj, I am going to get that kind of power from Bharati Maharaj. Believe me. He is so liberal. He used to love my Guru Maharaj so much. I cannot pay him. I am very lucky. My moth going to arrange his seva there. But the space is very small, but still. Anyway, I am begging for pardon unto his lotus feet if I have done any mistake in his unto his lotus feet, knowingly, unknowingly, both at the lotus feet of Haridas Thakur and Srila Bhaktivigan Bharati Maharaj, same day, same Bharati Maharaj Bhaji. So we are very lucky. We Vaishnav society getting that kind of Vaishnav. Is fill up the blank is not possible. Sometimes we can say, okay, we can fill up the blank. But I can say surely, this blank can never be filled up. I feel hard. What to do? We are going to miss him. But still his bani is there. I am very happy some of his writings published already. They are trying more and more to publish more of his writings and feelings so that I can get some extra benefit in my bhajan life. I don't understand what is bhajan. They can give kipa to me. Sadayam hidayam yasyo vacho sattabhushitam kayah parahitam yasyo kalihi tasyo karautikim bancha kalpadarosya kipasindhi bhavish patitanang pavane bhavishnabhyo namo. I pay Puspanjali unto the lotus feet of Bharati Maharaj through my bani. You have photo here? I can pay also. You have flower? No? No?
Yes.
You arrange? Chandan and flower. Any question you have? No? What question?
Because today, this Haridas Thakur so about Harinam, there's one verse, it is in Dhyana Chandra Padati. So there it said, Manoma Dhyesti Tomantro.
Okay. Many times I discuss it. When I am chanting mantra, my mind should be there inside mantra. And that mantra should grasp that total heart of mine. Manomuddhe, mantra should be there inside mine. Mantra going to grasp my total heart. Follow. This is actual mantra jap. You are doing mantra, your mind is there in Ukraine. You are doing mantra, your mind is there in Bangalore. It's not mantra. Follow? So it's quite natural. Bharati Maharaj, I have seen before Aruti every day, he used to get up very early and do chant Harinam. Whenever Aruti going to start, bell on, Bharati, it was the duty of Bharati Maharaj, we have seen in my life, in our life. Bhartima used to come in Nat Mandir. Bhartima used to come in Nat Mandir and stand. Nobody there. Nobody coming. Bhartima was standing and doing all stotra continuously like wind. Maybe 40 minutes or half an hour, more than 40 minutes. After that, Pujari opened temple, then arati started. Almost 1 hour, going on, speaking all stotra, kita. Usual practice. Before Mandir opened. You see the power of Bharati Maharaj. So, quite natural.